Will you have this wedding to be your wife? And will you pledge your faithfulness to her? Will you love her, cherish her, honor and comfort her, in sickness and in health, in hardship and in need, as long as you both shall live? If you consent, please say, I do. Will you have this man to your husband? And will you pledge your faithfulness? Will you love him, cherish him, honor and comfort him, in sickness and in trouble, in hardship and in ease, as long as you both shall live? If you consent, please say, I do. So, Erica and Andrew have written their vows, and they will be sharing those with us shortly, but they also sat down and talked to people a little bit and did something that people don't always take time to do, and that is to reflect on their relationship and share with us just a few of the things that they love about each other. And so we shared with you a few of the things that they shared with each other. As the E.E. Cummings poem says, they find their world in each other, and they are on a journey to discover what is inside this world that they are creating together. Erica says she loves about Andrew that he is supportive, honest, and caring. He may come across as standoffish. He has a strong and doesn't always seem easy to engage, but inside he is a big teddy bear. Thoughtful, kind, and demonstrative. He pays attention to anniversaries and holidays and cards and flowers. Emily keeps every card that Andrew has ever given her in a memory bulletin board. And if she is having a land They started having a blast. And one of the things they remembered, well, first of all, they remember a food tour that they took one day. And although Andrew doesn't usually like seafood, even though he worked in Gloucester, the home of seafood, he wouldn't eat, he doesn't do seafood, he says, but on food tour, they tried ceviche. Is that how you pronounce it? Do they remember what ceviche is? Yeah. Raw seafood salad? So that was one of those new great things they tried together. And then they talked about a bar that they were going to. And this bar was kind of, it's not an upscale bar. It was, the building was burned down, and it was a plot of land that was covered with artificial turf. Post-hurricane era lawn furniture, all mismatched. But the sun was sinking over the Atlantic. They had $2 mojitos and $5, whatever. They had really good drinks. And what they discovered was, it was one of the most beautiful places on earth. And maybe it was beautiful because they relaxed. And they could just be, after all the rushing that they had put in their life. I mean, you know these two, they've been on the go for a really long time, earning their degrees, working hard, taking care of everybody else's children and young generations. In that moment, they set time apart to be together with each other. And what they found was exactly what E.E. Cummings said, which is that their world is beautiful wherever they go, and they pause and they pay attention, and they're grateful for simply being together and loving each other and being present to the moment. That's the story that they share with us today, that their world is with each other and that they carry it with them and between them. And that the most simple, everyday place is made beautiful because they love each other and they're together. And now it's their turn to tell each other what they promised to each other.
First.
And at this time, we're going to prepare for the exchange of rings. Thank you. today. And so before God and before this gathering, I announce with joy that you are from this time on husband and wife. May I introduce Mr. and Mrs. Andrew and Erica Korman.